This is a picture test in practical histology of the endocrine glands. You may use the video as a revision for the topic or as a self-assessment tool. For the purpose of self-assessment, pause the video at the beginning of each slide and take your time in reading the question and coming up with the answer. Then replay the video to confirm your answer and listen to further comments and explanations. Identify the layer A and the region B. What is the function of B? This is a section of the adrenal gland showing an outer cortex and a central medulla. The layer marked A is not a glandular tissue, but is formed of connective tissue representing the fibrous capsule of the gland. B is the centrally placed medulla, consisting of closely packed clusters of secretory cells, numerous white capillaries and venules, and these cells of the adrenal medulla, they secrete the catecholamine hormones, adrenaline and noradrenaline, also called epinephrine and norepinephrine. Which hormone category is produced in each of the regions A, B, and C? This is again a section of the adrenal gland. Layers A, B, and C are the three histological zones of the adrenal cortex. From the surface inwards, they can be remembered by the mnemonic GFR, which also stands for glomerular filtration rate. They are the zona glomerulosa, G, that is represented in A, zona fasciculata, F, that is represented in B, and zona reticularis, R, that is represented in C. The layers are named according to the arrangement of the secretory cells, and you can see this clearly in the slide. In zona glomerulosa A, the cells are arranged in rounded clusters that look like glomeruli, hence glomerulosa. Zone B, which is the broadest of the three zones, it consists of parallel cords of secretory cells at right angles to the capsule, and hence the name zona fasciculata. They form fascicles of cells. Zone C is formed of small cells arranged in irregular cords like a reticulum or a network, and hence the name zona reticularis. The cells of the three zones, especially zona fasciculata, they have a pale, foamy appearance of the cytoplasm, because the cytoplasm is rich in lipid droplets, and these are necessary for the synthesis of the hormones secreted here. The hormones are mineralocorticoids, such as aldosterone, which is secreted from the zona glomerulosa, glucocorticoids, such as cortisol, from the zona fasciculata, and sex hormones, such as androgens, produced by the zona reticularis. As you might have noticed that these hormones control the three S's in the body. S for salt, mineralocorticoids, S for sugar, glucocorticoids, and S for sex, the sex hormones. Name the circumscribed structure A and the homogeneous material B. This is a section of the thyroid gland in which the functional units are the thyroid follicles, which are marked A. They are spheroidal structures lined by simple cuboidal epithelium. The homogeneous material in the center is called the colloid, and the thyroid gland is unique among the human endocrine glands in that it stores large amount of hormone in an inactive form within extracellular compartments in the center of the follicles. Other endocrine glands, they store small quantities of hormones in the inside the cell. Identify the cells indicated by A and B. What is the product of each? This is again a section of the thyroid gland showing thyroid follicles lined by follicular cells. One of them is marked in A. They are, as you can see clearly here, they are simple cuboidal epithelium, centrally located rounded nuclei. You can see that in the active follicles, the follicular cells extract stored thyroid colloid from the lumen and convert it into active hormones, T3 and T4. The scalloped pale edge of the colloid indicates where the colloid has been removed from the follicle during activity. Cell B is not located exactly in the follicle, it is around the follicle, parafollicular cell. Also, they are called C cells because they produce calcitonin. When blood calcium level is high, calcitonin inhibits the osteoclastic activity and it has a function that is opposite to the function of the parathyroid hormone. The parafollicular cells, they are individual cells, mainly located in the spaces between the follicles, and that's why they are called parafollicular cells, and they are larger and paler than the follicular cells. Also, you can see that in this parafollicular tissue, there are capillaries containing red blood cells and a meshwork of connective tissue, supporting connective tissue. This is a classical arrangement of an endocrine gland where the secretion of the gland goes into the blood. There are no ducts. Identify the organ, name the cells A and B, which one is implicated in the hormonal secretion. The right section gives the clue for the left one. In the lower left-hand corner of the right section, you can see the follicles of the thyroid gland. So the adjacent organ to the thyroid is the parathyroid gland. The parathyroid gland contains chief cells, or also called principal cells, and these are represented in A. They are small cells with round, centrally located nucleus. They synthesize and secrete the parathyroid hormone. The second type of cells, which is shown in B, are the oxyphil cells. They are large cells, eosinophilic cytoplasm. The oxyphil cells of the parathyroid gland are clearly larger and more eosinophilic than the chief cells. These cells, the oxyphil cells, can be found in clusters, and the function is not clearly known. Given the staining affinity of the cells in this gland, which part of the gland this section represents? Identify the cells A, what is their function, and identify the spaces indicated by the star. In this section, we can see anastomosing cords of cells supported by fibrous network, sinusoidal capillaries. Note the RBCs in the lumen of the vascular profiles, which are indicated by the star, by the asterisk. Also note that in this stain and many other common stains, three cell types can be recognized according to the staining property. Chromophils, chromo means color in Greek, and phyllon means to love. So these chromophils, they have affinity to color. So they are either have affinity to acidic dyes or the basic dyes. And so we have acidophils or basophils. The third category of cells are those whose cytoplasm has less affinity to stain, and they are called chromophobes. Phobos means fear, so they fear the stain. This is represented as an example in the cell indicated A. Such a description of the staining affinity of cells is typical for the anterior pituitary gland. The staining affinity is determined by the secretory granules on the cytoplasm. The chromophobes are also called chief cells because they are the most numerous. Although this is not reflected in this section, but it is actually the chromophobes constitute about 50% of the cells of the anterior pituitary. Their cytoplasm lacks specific granules or contain very small secretory granules. These cells are thought to be forming a supporting network for the other cells. However, most of the chromophobes are partially degranulated chromophils. They have very few granules. They represent degranulated chromophils and are capable of differentiating into one of the two chromophil types, either acidophils or basophils. So the function of these chromophobes is either supporting cells, or they are, in fact, they are secretory, but they represent a degranulated state. Given the staining affinity of the cells in this organ, name the cells A and B, give one hormone produced by each. This is the same anterior pituitary section as mentioned earlier. Chromophils have affinity for either acidic or basic dyes, so they are called either acidophils, like the ones represented in A, or they have affinity to basic dyes, and are thus called basophils, like the one represented in B. Basophils, as you can see here, are generally, they are larger than acidophils. Having two staining affinities of secretory granules doesn't mean that we only have two functional cell types. In fact, histochemical and immunocytochemical staining and electron microscopic features can differentiate five types of cells in the anterior pituitary according to their function. So we have somatotropic cells and mammotropic cells. Both of them are acidophils in conventional stains, but they can be differentiated by immunohistochemical techniques. These cells, they secrete the growth hormone and the prolactin respectively. And the basophils are in fact three types of cells: gonadotrophs that produce FSH and LH, thyrotropic cells that produce the thyroid stimulating hormone, and corticotrophs that produce the adrenocorticotrophic hormone. Identify the structures A, B, and C. Identify the area D. List two secretory products at this location. Where is the product in B discharged? This is a lobulated structure indicated by the fibrous septa between the lobes, like the one shown in A. So A is a fibrous septum. Generally, it looks like an exocrine gland that is much similar to the parotid gland. Note the secretory acini demarcated in B. The acinar cells are pyramidal in shape with a luminal apex and basally located nucleus. They have a cytoplasm packed with secretory granules. There is a duct, which is represented in C. This confirms the state of the section being an exocrine gland. So acini and ducts, these acini, they secrete into ducts. They are not secreting into the blood vessels. So this is an exocrine gland or exocrine part of a gland. The duct here, which is present in between the acini, are the smaller ducts called intercalated ducts. Again, I stress the duct is lined by simple low cuboidal epithelium. Larger ducts might be lined with taller cuboidal epithelium, sometimes stratified cuboidal. Generally, they are located in the connective tissue septa between the lobes. Now, apart from the exocrine glandular tissue, note here that there's a lighter stained area indicated in D. Lighter stained in comparison to the acini. These areas, lighter stained areas, are in fact scattered in between the acini. This is another one here, smaller one. These lighter stained areas reflect the endocrine component of this organ. This is thus the pancreas. It has both an exocrine and endocrine components. The lighter stained areas are in fact the islets of Langerhans. Islet cells, they produce glucagon, insulin, and somatostatin, and are designated as alpha, beta, and delta cells, respectively. However, these cells cannot be differentiated from each other by conventional stains. Since this is the endocrine part of the pancreas, I mean the islets of Langerhans, then there is no duct associated with them. The cells of the islets, they secrete their products to the blood. That's why the islet is associated with a rich network of capillaries. Returning to the last part of the question, where is the product in B discharged? The exocrine pancreas represented in B secretes an enzyme-rich alkaline fluid into the duodenum via the pancreatic duct. Identify the cells A and the structure B. This is again a pancreatic tissue with acini and lighter stained islets of Langerhans, like this one here. You can see multiple of these islets in the low magnification scattered in between the acini of the exocrine part of the pancreas. The cell marked A is in the center of some of the acini, and that's why it's called centroacinar cell. It's a feature of some, but not all, pancreatic acini. These centroacinar cells, they represent the terminal lining cells of an intercalated duct. B is a large interlobular duct, and you can see here that it is associated with blood vessels, like this one, an artery with a thick wall, and a vein with a thin wall and large lumen. B is identified as a duct, and not a blood vessel because of its lining epithelium. The lining epithelium is cuboidal rather than a squamous endothelium of blood vessels.